Hi, welcome to POIT. In this video, we are going to learn about the Azure Privileged Identity Management, which is known as the PIM. So I'm on the Azure portal right now. So let me search for PIM, Azure AD Privileged Identity Management. So Privileged Identity Management, it provides time-based and the approval-based role activation to reduce the risk of unnecessary or misused access permissions. By using this PIM, we can provide the time-based and the approval-based role activations. Now, let me show you how you can assign a role to the person in the organization. So first, we need to go to the Privileged Identity Management, then select Azure AD Roles and select Assign Eligibility. This option will be grayed out if you are not having the P2 license. If you are having the P2 license, then only you would be able to assign the eligibility. So here, a new person is going to join in the help desk. So let me assign the help desk administrator role. So these are all the roles that we'll be having in the Azure. So these are all the different types of roles that will be there in the Azure. You can see like the search administrator, the printer administrator. These are all the, see here, the global reader, the global administrator. Even you can see the billing administrator. So a new person is going to join in the IT help desk, and let me give the help desk administrator role to that person. So I'm going to assign this role. I want to assign this help desk administrator role to the person. So if I check, as of now, no one is eligible for this assignment. So here we have three options. One is the eligible assignments, one is the active assignments, and the other is of expired assignments. So eligible assignment means the person, the people who are there under the eligible assignments, they would be eligible. I means like they can activate the assignments and that role will be activated for those people. But if they are not eligible for that, then they would not be able to activate the assignments. And once someone activate the assignments and then it has been expired, then it will be showed here in the expired assignments. So as of now, we cannot find any user under the help desk administrator. So under the help desk administrator role, no one has been given with the eligible assignment, means no one is eligible for the help desk administrator role as of now. So let me give this role to this person for the first time. Okay, I'm going to click on the add assignments. Then here you can see the resource. The resource is the POIT. The resource type is the directory. Role, we have already selected help desk administrator. Scope, we are going to give the complete directory. And then now we need to select the member. So let me select the member. Let me give it to Rick Ted. Okay, I'm giving this help desk assigned administrator role to Ricky Ted. Let me click on select. Okay, now let me click on next here. So here it is asking the assignment type, either the eligible or active. So if I give the eligible, then this Rick, always he need to activate this role whenever it is required. And if I click on active, then it doesn't require, I mean that Ricky doesn't require to activate the role each and every day he logs in. It's very simple. If the assignment type is eligible, then that person is eligible for that particular role, and whenever he requires that role, then he can go ahead and he can activate it. But instead of that, if I give directly the active, then the role will be active for that person. And whenever he wants to use the role, he can use it. So let me go with the eligible. Then the next option is like maximum allowed eligible duration is permanent. If you want to give the role eligible permanent, you can select as like permanently eligible, or if not, if you want to give the time period. So you know the project time. So project is going to start by next month, it's going to end by after 6 months. Then you can give the assignment start and assignment end time. I'm going to give it as like permanently eligible. Then next we need to click on assign. So now let's see what if we go with the active role. So if you go with the active, the same options like permanently eligible, permanently assigned, or if not the particular time period. And here it is asking for the justification. So it is asking for the justification that why you want to give the active role for this person. So if you give the active role, then that role will be active all the time. And whenever he wants to use it, he can use it. But if we go with the eligible, then whenever that person requires the role, he need to activate the role. Then only he would be able to access the resources regarding to that particular role. Let me click on eligible. Let me scroll down and let me click on assign now. So here we can see that assigning role to a member. So once this role has been assigned, we have given it as like eligible. Then whenever Ricky, he requires that role, then he need to activate it. So here we can see that Ricky 10, he is eligible for the help desk administrator role. Now, if I want to make any changes to this role, then let me go to the role settings. If I go to the role settings, here I can see that activation maximum duration is for 8 hours. So once Ricky activate that role, it will be active for next 8 hours. So let me click on edit. If I want to make it the maximum of 24 hours, I can make it, or if I want to give it for only 5.5 hours, I can give it. And the next one is like on activation required. So whenever Ricky go ahead and active this role, then does he require the Microsoft authenticator? You can select it, or if not the Azure AD conditional access authentication, you can select it. So this conditional access, again, it will be a separate topic. So you would be coming to know about the conditional access in our next videos. Okay, here I'm going to set as like none. Then when this person going to activate the role will be activated for only 5.5 hours, and none of this is required. Like either we need to go with the MFA, or if not with the conditional access, none of this is required. And the next one is like he need to provide the justification, required justification on activation. So while activating, that person need to provide the justification, or if not the ticket number, or the require approval to activate. So require approval to activate means then again we need to select the approver email. Okay, so here let me select it as like PYT abroad user, the admin account. So whenever this person wants to activate this role, then the role will be active for only 5.5 hours. None of this is required. While activating, MFA is not required, and even the conditional access is also not required. But user need to provide the justification, and user need to provide the ticket number, and also user requires the approval. So once he submits that, then an approval email will be going to this person. To whom? To this person. But let me select as like require approval is not required. So based upon the organization requirements, you are going to update this. Even I'm going to select as like the ticket information on the activation also not required. So now let me click on assignment. So here you can see that allow permanent eligible assignments. So you can just, based upon the requirements, you can select all these options, like either it may be like a 1 year. If you uncheck this, then you can select it like 1 year, 6 months, or for how many time period. I mean like for how much time period you want to give, you can give it. Okay, then the notification. So when activating this role, the notification email should be sent or not. So here we can see that the role assignment alert will be going to the admin. Then you can select the additional recipients, like you, whomever, like the manager, or if not the head of the department, if you want to select, you can select. So then the email will be going to this all people whenever the role has been activated. Send notifications when member are assigned active to this role. And this is like send notification when members are assigned as eligible to this role. So right now I'm assigning this person eligible to this role, right? So then an email notification will be sent to the role assignment alert and notification to the assigned user and also to the request to approve a role assignment required. So if you mention any approval requirement, then even it will be going to the approver also. So these all options completely, it will be different from organization to organization and based upon their client requirements. So if you want to send the notifications when member are assigned as active, I mean, whenever the role has been activated, then the email notification will be sent. So let me click on update. Okay, so now the help desk administrator role has been given to the recruiter. So let me log in to the portal.azure.com with the recruiter account. On Microsoft.com. Let me give the password. So he's asking for the Microsoft Authenticator approval. We need to approve it on the Microsoft Authenticator app. So let me go ahead and let me approve it first. So I have approved it. Now let me click on yes. So I logged in as a recruiter. So now I have been assigned with the role, right? The help desk administrator. So let me go over here and search for PIM, Privileged Identity Management. So here, let me go to my roles. So I have been signed in with the recruiter account to whom we have assigned the help desk administrator role. So here under eligible roles, we can see that it is reflecting help desk administrator. Either it is active, no, it is not active because this person has not activated it yet. So let me go ahead and let me activate it. Activate. Reason. So it is asking for the custom activation start time. Then it is asking for the reason. So reason, let me put it as like BAU, business as usual. Let me activate this. So during the activation process, there will be three stages. The stage one will be like the processing the request, and the stage two will be validating, and the stage three will be activation process. So always remember, while activating any role, there will be three stages. Stage one will be calling it as the processing the request raised by the assignee, and the stage two will be called as like the validating of the role, and the stage three will be activation. So once this has been activated, then the page will be refreshed. So it will take around like 1 or 2 minutes to get the role activated. And after 5.5 hours, the role will be expired. The active role will be expired. So now if I go to the active assignments, it is not reflecting as of now. Let me refresh this. See the help desk, it is activated. If I go to the expired assignment, there are no expired assignments. So once this has been expired, then you can see it in the expired assignment role. So this is what meant by an privileged identity management. And this is how the IT admins or the cloud admins, they will be assigning the roles by using the privileged identity management whenever it is required. So always remember, by using the privileged identity management, the roles can be assigned based upon the time and based upon the approval. So by giving this, we can reduce the risk of unnecessary or misused access permission. So once this person logs out, then automatically this role will be going into the expired assignments. And if someone wants to access this role also, they would not be able to do it. So this is what meant by a privileged identity management. PIM. So we are also going to, we will be also calling this as the PAM. PAM is also same, the privileged access management or the privileged identity management. Thank you for watching this video, and for more videos, please do subscribe our channel and don't forget to like this video.